Hello, I'm Sylvia Azania. Today's video is about testicular hydrocele. We will explain the types of hydrocele, describe their symptoms, explain how they are diagnosed, and discuss the available treatment options. Additionally, we will also answer some of the most frequently asked questions that some users may have regarding this topic. The testicles are located inside a pouch called the scrotum. In the scrotum, the testicles are naturally immersed in a small amount of fluid that helps them remain mobile and also makes them less vulnerable to external impacts. Therefore, we use the term testicular or scrotal hydrocele when the amount of fluid in this area is greater than what is considered normal. Testicular hydrocele is the most common type of hydrocele, and approximately 5% of male newborns present with this condition. There are two main causes of hydrocele that lead to the two basic types of this condition, congenital hydrocele and acquired hydrocele. We are going to discuss each of them. Congenital hydrocele is a type of swelling in newborn babies. It is the most common type of testicular hydrocele, and it's also called a communicating hydrocele. This type of hydrocele occurs in cases when the tunica vaginalis of the testicle has not completely closed, thereby maintaining an open communication with the peritoneal cavity. This condition causes fluid to flow into the scrotal cavity, meaning that there is a passage of fluid into the scrotum. During normal development, the testicles descend slowly through a duct that runs from the abdomen to the scrotum. In this case, hydroceles occur when this duct fails to close properly. This allows fluid to pass through this duct, which remains open from the abdomen and accumulate in the scrotum. For this reason, the testicle appears swollen. Additionally, congenital hydrocele may or may not be accompanied by an inguinal hernia. This congenital hydrocele is very common in babies, but usually disappears between 18 and 24 months of age. If not, the communicating hydrocele requires surgery. In contrast to the previous type, the hydrocele can also be acquired or non-communicating. The main reason for the accumulation of fluid in non-communicating hydroceles is inflammation, which can develop due to a variety of different causes or underlying factors such as infections, testicular torsion, trauma, epididymitis, tumor, etc. On the other hand, surgery performed in the testicular area, including procedures such as a vasectomy, a varicocele intervention, or an inguinal hernia, could also be possible causes for the appearance of a hydrocele. Acquired hydrocele occurs in children and adults, but it is most common for non-communicating hydrocele to occur in men over 40 years old. The clinical manifestations of a hydrocele typically involve a painless inflammation or swelling of the affected testicle, or both testicles in the case that the hydrocele is bilateral. On some occasions, this inflammation can lead to pain and redness in the affected area. However, these symptoms are generally mild and do not prevent the performance of daily routines. The diagnosis of hydrocele should be made by a urologist who will perform the following tests. Palpation. The circulating fluid makes the testicle very soft and unnoticeable to the touch. Upon more carefully palpating the scrotal sac, the specialist will perceive the swelling, but note that the testicle is of normal size within the scrotum. Transillumination of the scrotum. It is a diagnostic test that involves applying a light source behind the scrotal sac in order to illuminate it and identify a hydrocele. When there is a testicular hydrocele, the scrotum lights up because it is filled with transparent fluid. Ultrasound. It is used to confirm the diagnosis of hydrocele and also to check that there is no testicular tumor. In addition to these tests, the specialist may also recommend performing a blood test and a urine test to check thoroughly for any infection that could be the possible cause of the hydrocele. And before continuing with the content of this video, I'm going to kindly ask you to give it a like and subscribe to the channel if you haven't done so already, as it helps us a lot to continue and ensures that all the information we publish can reach more people. Normally, the hydrocele is not considered dangerous and is only treated when it causes significant discomfort or when the testicles become so enlarged that they compromise normal blood flow. Generally, a simple hydrocele disappears without the need for treatment. However, there are cases where the hydrocele needs to be addressed. The two procedures that are currently used to eliminate a hydrocele are the hydrocelectomy and the scrotal aspiration. Hydrocelectomy is considered a low-complexity outpatient surgery that produces excellent results. The only issue is that it requires the use of either general or epidural anesthesia. In broad terms, a hydrocelectomy typically involves making a small incision either in the scrotum or in the lower abdomen. Through this incision, the excess fluid is removed, and part of the tissue is eliminated to prevent it from filling up with fluid again. The complications that may arise from operating on a hydrocele using the hydrocelectomy technique are as follows. Blood clots, infection, and injury to the scrotal tissue or structures. The duration of a hydrocelectomy is usually around 30 minutes, and after the surgical procedure, the patient can return home the same day as the surgical procedure. Once at home, the patient can apply ice to the affected area to help reduce swelling and take painkillers if these are advised by the specialist. The other treatment option for a hydrocele is to remove the fluid from the scrotum with a needle, known as scrotal aspiration. This aspiration is frequently associated with a sclerotherapy treatment that consists of injecting medications that cause hardening or thickening to effectively close the opening. The benefit of using this technique is that it helps prevent the subsequent accumulation of fluid. The risks associated with scrotal aspiration and sclerotherapy are as follows: fibrosis, infection, mild to moderate pain in the scrotal area, and recurrence of the hydrocele. Ultimately, due to the high risk of infection and the high likelihood of the hydrocele reappearing, surgery is generally preferred. Aspiration can be considered a good treatment option for patients who present certain surgical risks. Additionally, hydroceles that appear with an inguinal hernia should be surgically repaired as soon as possible, and a hernioplasty should be performed. And now, we are going to answer some of the most frequently asked questions that users may have related to this topic. Does a hydrocele cause infertility? A hydrocele is not a direct cause of infertility and usually does not drastically affect a man's reproductive capacity. However, there are cases of hydrocele where other factors that do influence fertility, such as an infection, may appear. Therefore, a hydrocele could indirectly hinder or interfere with the successful achievement of a pregnancy. In these cases, the option of surgery could be considered. Is it possible to have sexual intercourse after undergoing hydrocele surgery? After hydrocele surgery, it is usually recommended to wait about 2 or 3 weeks before engaging in sexual intercourse. However, this can vary between patients depending on the severity of the hydrocele and whether any complications have arisen. Therefore, it is always best to consult with a specialist and follow all their instructions. What are the possible complications of a hydrocele? Generally, a hydrocele usually does not cause or involve any complications during its course. However, even though it is not very common, in some cases testicular ischemia may occur, leading to a deficit in blood flow to the testicle, which could potentially affect its normal function. We would love to hear about your experience, so I encourage you to share it in the comments. And I would also like to remind you that in the description box, you will find a link to an article where you can read much more information related to this topic.